This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to recreate the iconic Star Wars Millennium Falcon hyperspace effect. I prepared this image for us of the iconic Star Wars Millennium Falcon cockpit. You can download it from the link in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, click that subscribe button to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. The first step is to make a new layer under the cockpit by control or command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with black, but before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard. If the colors are inverted, press X. To fill it with the black foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Copy the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J and temporarily hide the cockpit layer. We'll make the copy of the black layer into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. The amount is 100%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.5 pixels. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. Make the input black level 110 and the input white level 150. Shift-click the layer 1 copy to make it active as well, and convert the two active layers into a smart object. Make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Temporarily hide the two copies and make the original smart object active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. The amount is 100, the blur method is zoom, and the quality is best. Repeat the filter by pressing Ctrl-Alt-F on Windows or Command-Ctrl-F on a Mac. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. We want the adjustment layer to affect only the one layer below it. However, because adjustment layers affect all layers below them in the Layers panel, we'll need to clip it or restrict it by making it into a clipping mask. To do this, click the clipping mask icon, or you can go to Layer and create clipping mask. Make the input black level 37 and the input white level 70. Click the Levels 1 layer to make it active, and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. Make the size 700 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow are both 100%. Go to the center and click once. We'll increase the size of the radial zoom effect, but before we do, click off the chain link between the layer and the layer mask to unlink them. Doing this allows us to resize or reposition either of them independently of the other. Make the radial blur layer active and press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the smart filters will be temporarily turned off while using the transform tool. At the top, make sure the chain link icon is active between the transform's width and height. In either field, type in 155%. Then click Enter or Return twice. Shift-click the Levels 2 layer to make it active as well. We'll place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Make the Levels 1 copy visible and active. Change its blend mode to Linear Dodge. Open the Radial Blur filter and make the amount 10. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. Clip it to the Levels 1 copy. Make the input black level 44 and the input white level 133. Make the Levels 1 copy active and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. With your brush tool still active, we'll reduce its size by pressing the left bracket key on our keyboard 2 times, so its size is 500 pixels. At the center, click once. Shift-click the Levels 3 adjustment layer to make it active as well. Then, place them into a folder. Make the Levels 1 copy 2 layer visible and active, and change its blend mode to Linear Dodge. Open the Radial Blur filter and make the amount 20. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open the Layer Style window. We'll be using the Blend If filter to achieve the next effect. Blend If basically uses the luminosity of layers to blend them together. The current layer is the active layer, and the underlying layer represents all the layers below the active layer in the Layers panel. By dragging the left black slider of the current layer, we're making the blackest blacks disappear on the active layer. In other words, pixels to the left of the black slider will be transparent, and pixels to the right of the black slider will be visible. For this example, let's drag it to 70. We'll place all the radial blur layers into a folder by shift-clicking the Group 1 folder to make all 3 radial blur layers active. Press Ctrl or Command G. Make a new layer above it. Open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl or Command-click any of the thumbnails to select all the tones. Open back the Layers panel and hide the folder. So now we have a selection of the combined tones of the radial blur layers against a black background. We'll fill the selection with white, and since our background color is white, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Double-click the thumbnail of Layer 2 to open its Layer Style window. Click Outer Glow and the Color Box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 0048FF. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 75%, and the noise is 0%. The technique is softer, the spread is 0, and the size is 10 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Make a copy of the layer, which doubles its brightness. Make the original layer active, and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. Increase your brush's size to 1100 pixels. Go to the center and click once. Make the cockpit visible. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.